Hey gang, what we're now gonna do is take a look at probability proportional to size. Understanding all the details, all the minutia that goes on in this will probably help you answer even a simple multiple choice question. So we're gonna take a couple of minutes and show you the mechanics that go into this process. Part of this process is literally understanding the given information and then applying it to a large set of facts. So we're gonna take a look at this one. Very first thing we're gonna have to do is understand that the sampling interval will be based on given information. The given information will be, they'll tell you what the tolerable misstatement is. They'll tell you the reliability factor. All we do is divide those two to come up with the sampling interval. We then apply that to the population, say receivables, and we're told at what increments we have to do it. Let's move on to our next slide. So let's take a fact pattern. We're going to audit accounts receivable. In this case, the sampling interval given to us and the tolerable misstatement. Tolerable misstatement, 25,200. 3 is the reliability factor. So when we divide that, we're going to look at every account that is part of the cumulative balance that literally came up to that increment. We're going to show you and explain that one in just a moment. Since the entire accounts receivable is 318,000, we divide it by the interval that we'll be testing at, and we realize we're going to test about 38 items. So let's go on to our next slide. And by the way, we're going to have a random start at 1,000. So the first account that cumulatively brings the receivables up to $1,000, that account we're going to audit. Then as we look at other receivables and they get added to the cumulative balance, the one that equals or gets us to 9,400, that account we're going to audit. Then the next one that gets to 17,800, which is another 8,400, we'll audit that one, then we'll audit the next one at increments of 8,400. So let's go on to our next slide. Well, here are the customers that were in the receivables. And by the way, there were a lot of them, like 65 of them. The first customer, 1,500. The next customer had a balance of 3. The next one, this one. So they each had different balances. Obviously, let's go to the next slide. You'll notice the cumulative is 1,500. And since our random starting point is the first one that gets us to 1,000, that will be selected. The next account was 3,000, cumulatively 4,500. We're not going to audit that one. The next one was 1,400, cumulatively bringing us up to 5,900. We're not going to audit that one. The next one was 4,350. That brought us up to 10,250. That brought us into the 9,400. Remember, 1,000 plus 8,400 equals 9,400. So that one account we're going to audit. Then the next one brought us up to 12,500. Not doing that one. Next one up to 5,000. Not going to do that one. Ooh, the next one, 12,500. That brought us up to the account that would have equaled $17,800. So we're going to audit that one as well. So we're going to pick them based on which one got us to 1,000, which one got us to 9,400, which one got us to 17,800, which one got us to 26,200, and so on and so forth. Let's go to the next slide. You can see here that the ranges tell you what they are. Let's go to the next slide. And therefore, that one is 1,000. So we're going to audit that customer there. Let's go to the next slide. Since the next one would be the 9,400, and that is within that range, we're going to audit that customer. Let's go to the next slide. Now, what's interesting here, and I have a little light bulb telling us, aha, good idea. We see that in this particular case, we're looking for one at 17,800. That fell there. And then the next account was 26. So we actually have 2 in that particular one. So since 2 of our numbers fell within the same range, we get to send one less confirmation. That is one of the advantages of probability. Let's go on to our next slide. And you'll notice that the next category, if you took 26,200 and added 8,400, you'd look for whatever account got you up to 34,600. And that account was here, so we're going to audit that one. So these are just some of the accounts we're going to audit. Let's go on to our next slide. Well, we sent out confirmations. You'll notice these are the confirmations, and we ask them in a positive way, is the balance correct? And if it's not, what is the correct balance? So we sent them out for the various customers that had been selected based on the probability. Next slide. Well, this one said it was right. This one said it was wrong and gave us a different balance. This one said it was wrong and gave us a different balance. This one said it was right. Okay, so we got our results. Let's now go to our spreadsheet. And on our spreadsheet here, if no error was found, the error projection is 0. book value, audited value, at the increment of zero. Let's go to the next slide. The next one was we tested an account that had a $43.50. However, the client, the customer, said it was only $39.15. It was off by $435. Ironically, that's 10%. So 10% in this case is off. So we'll notice 10% projected error in this case, $840. Let's go to the next one. The next one here, and this one's interesting. If the book value of the selected item is greater than the sampling interval, and I do emphasize that, then the amount of the error, not the projected value, is going to be used. And that's important to understand in this particular case. So what I'd like to do is emphasize that by showing you how that calculation is done. So if you'll notice, the interval here was 12,500. In this case, we have the interval, and I'm sorry, it was 8,400, but the book value was 12,500. Remember, the intervals, every $8,400 we're doing it. Every $8,400, these were smaller than the interval, but 12,500 is larger than the interval. So in that one case, you'll notice what we're going to do, we're going to show just the actual amount of the difference. Then we had one that was 8,000, that all agreed. So therefore the projection was there. So based on the projected error on just these items, we had the one which was 10% of the range, and the other one was larger, so it just became the actual amount of the error. We believe that $1,090 is going to be the projected error on this particular accounts receivable total balance. Hopefully that helps, and we're ready to move on.